things to put a strong name or a simple banner or all encompassing banner. This is India Century Mission, by which we have to energize ourselves, energize all like-minded people for integration. For example, if you daily think and pray that we must be integrated, integrated and integrated, whatever we do, they are not pre-planned like what we have done before, a month to plan to organize this seminar. It is not equally to be planned, or it is not equally to be thought like that. If we have done something today, that is the cumulative effect of our craving which we had for several decades. So the more craving you have to meet more youth, to meet more energetic people, to have more patronage, to move towards the society with more propagation and feminization, the more craving you have, the craving that magnetism creates automatically lot of affinity, attraction and intimacy between like-minded people to create a potential inner globe within our minds or within our community. That is the greatness. Regarding the greatness of India, I have to say 2 points and conclude the session. Number one, there is a quality known as collision endurance. Collision endurance, you know that, for example, if the tail of the lizard is cut off, immediately it will grow. The stem of a plant, the nail of a person. Likewise, in spite of invasions, interventions, dilapidations, colonizations, cultural inclusions, and various other things that trampled the nervous system of India, still it lives. It survives in India and flourishes in non-Indian countries. So that is the greatness of India. It is known as collision endurance, number one. And after Indian War of Independence and Indian freedom after 1947, no proper or no conspicuous or no consolidated revolution has been undertaken. We have driven out the foreign elements. But lot of unwanted things which are there upon us, which are pesting upon us, which are parasitically affiliated to our inner source and squeezing out our energy and dynamism and cultural values, those things they have to be driven out by a second revolution, which has not happened since the Indian independence. There should be a proper time to create a proper integral force for working against these evil forces, which are nothing but they should be amputated by a vigilant spiritual social surgery. For this we have to take a mission, and it is not by a battle but by a binding, that is a democratic binding, that is a spiritual binding we have to bring. No doubt we want collision endurance, but how long you can be conducting only collision tests and not making the trial of drive? We have to drive something. How long you can conduct these things? And somebody asks, what is the difference between evil yesterday and today? Evil was there everywhere. Evil is eternal and ubiquitous. Then I told that in earlier centuries or in earlier yugas, we had sample of evils. Now we have supply of evils. So that is a very great thing. So when we have sample that evil also exists, that is different. Now evil is systematically, there is a stock keeper, there is a storage mechanism, there is a distributor, there is an agent, there is a manufacturer, there are containers for distribution or supply of the evil. That is the problem now. So what we have to do is, we have to institutionalize this. How to institutionalize this? By means of making a fund to create an institute, to make a syllabus, and to do everything to be propagated. Wherever the people are accessible, most of the people are not accessible. Even God is accessible, most of the people we cannot go. Such a type of cultural disharmony is there in the society. We can pray for them. We can meditate for those who are inaccessible, and we must propagate for the accessible. For that, we want some energy. Whatever we have in the form of books and speeches, innumerable things are there. Lot of great orators they have spoken, and great think tanks they have written books. What we want is presentation. How you are going to present it in a palatable, assimilable and practicable manner to the modern society, number one. Number two, how you are going to make it create an impact in the society. Anybody can speak, but how to create an impact? Impact creation is of also three types. One is a water writing impact, second is an ink writing impact, third is a hot seal press impact. If just we speak about something which we forget whenever we move outside, then that is useless. Whenever we have those things but we don't do, that is also useless. That is like ink mark. You must make a hard seal press, which is possible only by meditation, which is possible only by our total surrender to God and transcendental personalities who are embodiments of radiation, by which we can also imitate, or we can also be inculcated, or we can be bestowed by the power of God, power of His clemential shower. We can be capacitated enough to deal with these people with hard seal press radiation. That is what we are going to do. I wish and bless. This is the first seminar of its kind. in Spirituality, Science and Society. I wish and bless all the participants to be proper listeners, all listeners to be proper carriers, all carriers to be proper conductors, all conductors to be proper transmitters, resulting in all round peace and happiness. That is the message. That is the mother's milk of India to the whole globe. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.